Now let's take a look at even exponents. Consider 5 raised to the second power. We know that that is 25. And negative 5 raised to the second power is also 25, and it's positive too. When we clear an even exponent, we have plus or minus. We always have to remember that there could have been a negative or a positive value that was squared. So we always have to remember to include a plus and a minus. In example 1, we have 5x minus 2 raised to the second power. The opposite of that would be taking the square root, undoing that exponent. Whatever we do to one side, we have to do to the other, and so we're left with 5x minus 1 is equal to plus or minus 7. Next, we solve for x. We do this by adding 1 to both sides, and that gives me 5x is equal to 1 plus or minus 7. Notice the plus or minus sticks with the 7 right out front of the 7 throughout the remainder of this problem. Dividing by 5 to isolate x, we get x is equal to 1 plus or minus 7 over 5. We should get 2 different solutions or values for x at this point. The plus option, 1 plus 7, would give me 8/5, and the negative option would be 1 minus 7, or negative 6/5. So x is equal to 8/5 or negative 6/5. In example 2, we again have an even exponent, and to undo the exponent, we're going to take the 4th root of that. Whenever we take an even root, we have to allow for the positive and the negative options. So we have to write plus or minus. We know that 81 is the same as 3 to the 4th. So we can rewrite this as 3x plus 2 is equal to plus or minus 3. Solving for x, we subtract 2 from both sides. Again, remembering that the plus or minus doesn't do anything, it stays with that 3. Now I'm going to divide both sides of my equation by 3 to isolate x. So now I have x is equal to negative 2 plus or minus 3 divided by 3. Allowing for both options, my positive possibility would be x is equal to negative 2 plus 3, or 1/3. My negative option would be negative 2 minus 3, or negative 5/3.